she wants one of my friends to call it. later, Duncan was sorting out the goods for the market towns when the station master came up. "Leave your trucks, please, Duncan. There's an emergency down at Small Engine Docks. The thing controller wants you to go and sort it out straight away." "A joke card," began Duncan. "Never mind that," the station master said. "The thing controller needs you double quick. Use turbines. Heat up Percy's something jolty while he was away at the docks. There's some harsh spots he can't go wrong, so he might take your goods along with his. But he's got one truck. He can manage with the lorries, huh? Good thinking." The grumpy barge was a barge used for carrying stone. He was a disagreeable barge. Nothing was ever right for him, and he grumbled unceasingly. Trucks grumbled too, but there weren't a patch on the grumpy barge. "Come on," shouted Bun, which was the barge's name. "Where aren't your trucks where you should be? How can they be loaded if you're dawdling about up there, eh?" "There's no engine, and we can only go where we're put. You're in the wrong place, not us," retorted the trucks crossly. They argued for some time, but it made no difference. Bun was in the wrong spot, and he was not due to leave until the next day. But he wasn't going to let a little thing like that stop him complaining. When Duncan arrived, Bun was sulky, and the trucks were annoyed with him. "Our stone is for Bun," they said. "Please put us in to the red siding so we can load him up and be rid of him as soon as possible. No trucks." "I've got a better idea," said Duncan. "I know the barge when visiting my sister, we charge a reward. So, watch what I can do to shut him up." He asked Cranker to put him on Bun to make him crack up. He did.
"Hello, Bun. Long time no see. What's this?"
"Oh, it's your Duncan. What are you doing on me?"
"You're heavy.
Teaching you a lesson." Crack went for some more. "Quick, Cranky, get me off, head mate."
He was back on the line just in time.
Ow!
I'm broken. The chunks wiped knees. Duncan taught him a lesson. A sinking lesson. And he took them to where they were to be delivered. Nothing but a bother he was, they said to each other. Always barging in and moaning about not being herded fast enough. They snickered. This time he got a tall heavy load. He didn't really bargain for. Serves him right if you ask us. Duncan was finished with the stone work, but he went to sort out the mess of bum, taking him to the scrapyard where he would be heard again. That bugged me a lot when I was working in a dock. In the red water kink railway, that's the end of him.
He chuckled.